Hey guys, welcome back to our channel, and today I'm doing a part four. And we're on part four now of NCIS Purcell stories. So, if you have not seen, I'm filming this on Wednesday, but y'all probably not seen this video until Friday or Saturday or sometime this weekend. So it's like the day after this episode airs, or if you have not seen the episode, go watch it before you even see about this video, because there's going to be some spoilers. There'll be some kind of thing. If you have not seen it, I will stop this video and go see the episode, or come back and watch this video whenever you get a chance to watch the episode. So, last night was really pretty hectic. Let's see, yesterday was April 18th, today's the 19th. I'm doing this video so I can, like, I have, like, a lot of stuff on my brain and stuff, you know, about it. Because last night was so hectic about what everything happened. And yes, there was some personal scenes, I can tell you that. And my acne is so bad. Like, I don't wear makeup in my videos, and makeup won't cover this at all. So, please excuse my acne. I'm a teenager, so I get acne. That's like the worst thing about me and a teenager, you get acne everywhere. But, let's see, Percy was in this episode, finally, because she hadn't been in a bunch. But the only thing is, last night, there's not going to be an episode next week. You have to wait, I have to wait like another week or two before it comes back on. And I get really mad about that because it's kind of a cliffhanger. I think that episode last night was kind of a cliffhanger to me because I'll tell you guys, if you've seen the episode, you know what I'm talking about. Okay. Percy comes back. Now let me try to put this in detail. Okay. It's recording on my TV so I can go back and watch it if I need to. If it ain't deleted off the DVR. But, okay. This ain't how the show actually starts. This is like 5 minutes, 10 minutes into it. So, yeah. So, LaSalle was on the phone with Gregorio, I think. Yeah, Gregorio. And he was going to pick Percy up from the coffee shop. So, he gets out of the vehicle, talking to Gregorio, you know, like, telling about a case that they're having and stuff. And so-called Percy was on a date with this guy, like a coffee, like just coffee, you know. But as they walk out of the coffee shop, LaSalle sees her, because he's like straight ahead, but she don't see him yet. And I don't believe this guy just walks up to her and kisses her and walks away. And mainly we didn't see him in any other part of the episode, so if you watched it, you know, we didn't see him in a part of the episode. So LaSalle sees her, and Percy walks up. He got off the phone with Gregorio, and something about, hey, I didn't know, like, Percy would say, hey, I could have picked you up, you know, I didn't know you were coming to pick me up or not. Something about, I have a case and all, and he was real grouchy, or real aggravated, or real pissed, or something. I think it's jealousy. I think that's what everybody thinks. And out of nowhere, they get over there, and Percy sees Gregorio and all. Then before, LaSalle says something about, I'm sorry, I have to get on my brain a little bit. Something about asking Gregorio what kind of case you got, because they were on the scene of a murder. Not really a murder, because it wasn't a murder. It was like, people got shot, you know, and they ran away and all. So after that, so let's get on forward to Percy and LaSalle. That night they were looking, like, they were, because they're walking, like, break into a house and all, but the girl, a woman, I think, was found dead. And before they walked in, they were in the, in person, that's how I was struck, and something about, and the person was like, why are you so mad? Like, he's like, I'm not mad, and he's like, you are mad, or something like that. And it would be a good thing if I were doing this video while the TV show was on, and just do a live stream, but I couldn't do a live stream about it, so, excuse that. But anyway, Like, the staff officer said, I didn't know you were dating anybody. He's like, I'm not dating nobody. It was just, oh, that guy, or whatever the guy's name was. I think she said the guy's name, but I didn't really know. And he's like, I'm not dating. It was just coffee. But he was talking about, just coffee, he came up and kissed you. Because that guy that she had coffee with that morning kissed her. And he saw her. Saw it. And he was like, he kissed me. And I really don't know. So anyway, on past that, and after he said that, at first, like, are you jealous? He was like, then I think he said no. Then he totally got off subject and, like, we're here for a case. We need to go find this woman and see if she's still alive or see what's going on in this house. So they totally skipped over it. He skipped over it. So she was sitting in the truck for a minute. She's like, she was probably thinking, he's jealous. Like, something's wrong with him. He's jealous. So on from that. This comes up to the last part of the show, which this part was kind of my favorite. The other part right behind it really wasn't. So this girl, well, Percy let this girl go, like this girl that was in part of this murder investigation or something, like about guns and, you know, stealing guns, like how they're supposed to get these guns to these people and, you know, all that. So mainly, well, and they finally got to this girl and they were having a shootout because these other people were like in this van or something. So they were trying to, Percy went after the girl and went after the girl, and the girl was convincing Percy to let her go, get out of the United States, you know, just go, because she can't go to jail, or she has to get these guns to these other people. And it turns out Percy let her go, and it was all on camera, and she got in big trouble. I want them to release her. Like, I could tell you how I was sitting last night when I was watching the show. I was on the edge of the couch doing this. Really? Really? Like, seriously? You know, Percy, tell the, you know, the head of everything that it controls if you're fired or not. She did not say anything, but before she left, her and LaSalle was talking because LaSalle was waiting on her, which I think that was very, very cute. I probably wasn't the only one that thought it was cute, but it was so cute though. That was before all that happened with they had to go, everything else. So after a little while, LaSalle, like, after Percy got through talking to Pride upstairs, it was like close to the end of the episode. So after she got through doing that, she came downstairs and LaSalle went on. He was the only one there just waiting for her. And I thought there would be a kiss. I was wrong, but I didn't say anything. I thought they were going to kiss, you know, because they were that close to each other. Like, I thought he was going to grab her and kiss her. I wish that would happen. That would turn the whole ending around for me. The ending was pretty good, but the ending kind of freaked me out a little bit. Like, they're just gonna drop her off the show, isn't it? Hopefully in the next episode that she will get out of jail, she will tell the truth, or at least give her a few weeks of suspension, or give her a few days of suspension, you know? And but, let's just say this. After that happened, like, and she told LaSalle, she let the girl go. And he was looking at her, and she was probably like, no, I don't want to hear it from you. And before she walks out, King from upstairs came and saying, I just got off the phone with so-and-so about, you know, probably the head of NCIS or something like that. I forgot what the name of it was, that we need to be downtown or somewhere right now. So I was like, oh my goodness. And then all the time when that was happening, they were saying, Just say if you did or not, or you're in big trouble. And that's really what happened. I forgot what the other things was. I know King was talking about Hamilton. That mayor is a crook. Like, he thinks he's genius. He can get everything because he's the mayor. Like, I wish they would just catch him already, but somehow they don't have proof of everything. And they were trying to get proof, but they did not get proof. Like, nope. They did not get proof. So anyways, after that happened, King walks out of the courthouse or something, and LaSalle is right behind him saying, "Where's Percy?" And there was a little space between that. King says she's going to jail. That really kind of why couldn't Percy say anything? You know, she could have said something. I'm on Purcell's side, so I'm not, you know, regretting with her or anything. But yeah. So yeah, that is mainly what happened on NCIS Purcell Moments. But this is the end. When LaSalle asked, "Where's Percy?" King said she's in jail, and he was like something like that. I really don't know. It's kind of weird. Face. If I could find a picture, I'll put a picture of it right over here, how he looked. Which, you know, everything like that. And what is that on my TV? Oh. Anyways. So, hope you guys enjoyed this Purcell cut video again. Thank you guys so much. I'm not really sure if I'm at like 1,000 views on my first Purcell story or not. But let me pull it up real quick. But it is so, I get like a lot, I have a lot of views. Alright, I want to go to my channel. But, yeah. So, thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you guys in my next video. Hopefully, my next Purcell story will be, "Oh, they got together." Hopefully, that'll happen. So, I hope you guys enjoy. And I'll see you guys in my next video. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe if you're new. I will see you guys in the next one. Bye.